practice test number one. I thought I would experiment with making a process video, which I've never really done before. Not really, a little bit. And the neighbor's cat is at my window. This has been happening. The ink I make myself, and okay, so I'm Suzanne, and I wanted to experiment with documenting my painting process. I participated in an online art therapy women's group through Curam Collective, which is founded by Chelsea Call, and she facilitated the group. And she is a graduate of the college that I'm also attending, or that I'm attending. It's called Southwestern College. It's a graduate school for art therapy and counseling. And anyways, yeah, so not sure if I want to go into that, but I guess I could cut this part out. I've been for a while now painting with plant dyes and inks, and I have been painting with black walnut ink and in Asheville after attending art school in Ireland at the Burren College of Art. And there I was painting with blackberries. I did a self-portrait series with blackberries. So I've been for a while now just experimenting with all sorts of foraging things from the landscape and using that as art materials, mainly plant dyes. And then I decided to take a sharp left turn and go to art therapy school. The main reason that I was attracted to this particular school, Southwestern College, is because it was originally founded as a mysticism college. Its origins are in mysticism. So there's indigenous Native American spiritual traditions and wisdom woven throughout the curriculum. So they're attempting to sort of bridge these two worlds, and I thought that that was really fascinating. And it also happens to be an art therapy school, and it's out here in northern New Mexico in Santa Fe, so it caught my attention for that reason. And it's been an interesting journey. And Chelsea is a graduate of Southwestern College, and she started this organization called Curam, and that is an Irish word that means care and responsibility and a sense of family. And I love that, because that's what that group felt like to me. It's just, even though it was online, just having like this group to meet with every week and feel cared for and feel like there was a touchstone, like a feeling of family, which I don't really have that in my life very much at all, and I haven't for a while. So I come from a very dysfunctional family and am not in contact with them. A very uncomfortable thing for me to talk about publicly, but I want to, so I don't have that in my life, and I know a lot of people don't have that in their life, and it's very challenging, at least for me. It's very challenging sometimes, and sometimes it's not. But I really appreciated Chelsea's Curam group, and Chelsea agreed to accept a partial trade of a painting in exchange for part of the payment for the group. And it took me way longer than I said I was going to, but I wanted to feel really good about it and really proud of it. So I did a photo shoot of Chelsea, and I painted her portrait on watercolor paper with black walnut ink.
Gate of the North, Arden Copper. I was alone, I knew the names of my loves. Four-legged and wings, mycelium branches and fins under the ocean. Totems of what we would call God, the creator.
crashed into the ocean, while the whales would sing along with the people of the salmon, with the people of the rice, with the people.
I wanted to paint flowers in the background. I had this vision of like orange and yellow flowers happening in the background, and that was just like in my head, like I knew that's what I wanted to do from the beginning. And I realized that it was because I had been going into the co-op near my house, and right when you enter the co-op, there was this beautiful display of these incredible flowers, which I later learned are called Icelandic poppies, but yeah, they were just like breathtakingly beautiful, really tastefully presented in these beautiful vases, something that I just feel like I could just see the love that was put into them, to these little flower arrangements, and I felt very drawn to it, and I really appreciated what someone had obviously very thoughtfully put together. So I painted one of them, and then the rest of them, yeah, all the petals fell off, and so I went back to the store to get some more, and they were gone. And so I looked up the farm that they're from, Minnie Falls Farm, and I contacted them and asked if I could get more, and they said that they were done for the season, that they had been blooming for 7 months, and now they were done completely, there was no more. And so I had one flower on this painting, and I did have the photographs, but I was like, oh no, what am I gonna do? And I was very attracted to this farm. You know, like I said before, there is something special about these people, I could tell. So I looked up their website, very beautiful energy in it. And I asked if I could come out there, and I went out there. It's on the way to Taos, really beautiful drive out there. And Lindsay is one of the owners, and she was so generous and gave me a tour of the whole farm. And she was right, no more Icelandic poppies, they're gone. But I bought a bunch of other flowers anyways, and just filled my drafting table area with them. Yeah, it was really special to go out there and to have all those flowers. And there are other smaller poppies that were along that trail that I noticed, and they were of a similar color. So I took some of those back to my house, and they were so exquisitely beautiful, those flowers. And they close at night and open in the daylight. So they're like, you know, they're like going to bed at night and waking up in the morning. It was such a joy to live with them for a while. And I painted those from life. And then I did use some of the photographs to paint from for the other Icelandic poppies that I added. And my neighbor has some other of those smaller poppies that I noticed hers were slightly different. The coloring was more solid orange than the ones I had found along the river trail. So I added one of those in there. And I originally was gonna fill the whole, all around her head with flowers, but then there was a moment when I had what I decided to end with, and I felt like that's perfect. I like it like that. So right when I was feeling complete with it.
No!
The watercolors themselves are really special. So right before I started this painting, I was out in San Francisco with my friend Melanie, and she worked at a watercolor store there called Case for Making, which is a really beautiful, special, small niche watercolor store where they make their own watercolors there. Alexis is the owner, and I'll put her info below so you can contact that store if you want. And I got some beautiful handmade watercolors from there that Melanie had sent me before. And then as soon as I got back home from San Francisco, I was walking with a friend along Canyon Road, and I discovered another watercolor store that had just opened on Canyon Road that is almost identical to Case for Making. Is this the same vibe, the same very small niche handmade watercolor store? And I talked with the owner, Sarah, I think her name is, and my neighbor's cat again is here. Mika. And so, and it turned out that the owner of this watercolor store, which is a French name, and I can't remember what it is, but I'll put it in the, I'll put it below. So her name is Sarah, and her and Alexis are friends and learned how to make watercolor paints together. And so I thought that was amazing. And I had run out of yellow. So I went and bought one from her, and it was like, yeah, beautiful, freshly made, handmade watercolor. So I started off with that, and that's the watercolors that I used. And I will just throw in there that during this process, I started learning how to make my own watercolors from earth-based pigments, and I've been watching some artists online who do that, especially in this New Mexico area. One of them is Stella Maria Bear. I'll put her link below too. But so I went out to Abiquiu and I got some dirt from the mountains there, and I've started the process of making pigment from those different colors. It's so beautiful. I'm excited about that. Okay, bye. Breaks my heart. I'm gonna go.